For what purpose does the gentlelady from California rise?
Mr. Chair, I have an amendment at the desk.
The clerk will designate the amendment.
Amendment number 71, printed in the congressional record, offered by Ms. Bass of California.
The gentlelady from California is recognized for 5 minutes.
Mr. Chair, this bipartisan amendment is simple. It prohibits the Defense Department from being used to engage in or facilitate human trafficking. Thousands of private contracting defense firms, including some of the industry's biggest names, such as DynCorp International and Halliburton subsidiary KBR, have been linked to trafficking-related incidents. Thousands of nationals from impoverished countries are lured by the promise of good jobs, but sometimes end up victims of scams that leave them virtual slaves with no way to return home or seek legal recourse. Despite this, allegations against federal contractors engaged in illegal labor practices ranging from contract worker smuggling to human trafficking in Iraq and Afghanistan continue to surface in the media. A recent New Yorker article illustrates the urgent need for this amendment. The article tells the story of two women from Fiji who thought they were going to lucrative jobs in Dubai, but ended up, quoting the article, unwitting recruits for the Pentagon's invisible army of more than 70,000 cooks, cleaners, construction workers, beauticians, etc., from the world's poorest countries who service U.S. military contracts in Iraq and Afghanistan. These two women were asked to deliver resumes, hand over passports, submit to medical tests, and they had to pay $500 to a recruiting firm. They were lured to Iraq under false pretenses and then told they would be making $700 a month. That was after they believed they were going to be making $3,800 a month, 10 times the normal salary in their home country. What they didn't realize was that they were contracted to work 12 hours a day, 7 days a week. They were also victims of sexual harassment and assault. After complaining, they were sent off base for making month while their passports and ID badges were confiscated by the subcontracting company. The company that hired them was initially reprimanded, but still operates in Fiji and still has a contract with the U.S. military. Meanwhile, allegations against federal contractors engaged in commercial sex and labor exploitation continue. Mr. Chair, I'd like to yield to the gentlelady from New York.
The gentlelady from California must remain on her feet.
Okay. I move to strike the last word, and I rise in strong support of this amendment, which will prevent U.S. taxpayer dollars from being used to facilitate human trafficking and labor abuses on U.S. military bases. As co-chair of the Bipartisan Congressional Caucus on Trafficking, I am particularly concerned that workers from South Asia and Africa are being trafficked to work on U.S. military bases, and that U.S. taxpayer dollars are spent to unlawfully lure and transport them to work in extreme conditions. It is Army policy to oppose all activities associated with human trafficking. This must include the supply chain that provides services to our service members defending our country. We must have strong oversight over our contracting system to ensure that it is free from human rights abuses, and this amendment works toward that end. I urge my colleagues to join us in fighting human trafficking in support of this amendment. And I yield back to you.
The gentlelady from California controls the time.
I guess I'd like to yield to the gentleman from Chicago.
I would just like to advise the gentlelady that I consider this an extremely important amendment, and I'm happy to accept it.
Thank you.
And we'll be glad to accept the amendment. We appreciate your hard work on this effort.
Thank you.
Does the gentlelady yield back or yield to the gentleman from Illinois?
I would like to yield to the gentleman from Illinois.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I just simply will extend in my remarks in support of the amendment. And thank the gentleman for accepting it, and I yield back the balance of our time.
Gentlelady from California.
I yield back the balance of my time.
Gentlelady yields back. Does the gentleman from New Jersey wish to speak on this?
No, I do not.
further speakers. The question is on the amendment offered by the gentlelady from California. Those in favor say aye. Those opposed say no. In the opinion of the chair, the ayes have it. The amendment is agreed to.